Violence against women on the whole, I believe, is an advantage to women, especially if we cannot defend our own self. For instance, a man may come home. Yes, you leave your family home, which is your wife or your mother, with all the children, and sometimes you may come home and see the place. Sometimes a man walk in a place, they have children, they have a madam, right? They expect a madam to do everything in the house. They still want to wash, cook, clean, and still see about children. They're looking to pick an argument, but that's the madam. And from one thing to one, we need to the next. So I believe in to be humble. Sometimes when they start, because in my book, two wrong don't make a right. He may come home, he might see something he like, and as you start to give him some kind of word to word, well, who tell you? Back and I'll go in and start. So sometimes I believe like one must back down and let it heat in the other person, like he now come home. When he don't get on, I believe he will boil on to my standard, and then he may want to listen to hear what it is I have to tell him. Because sometimes the time he meet with me, don't want to hear why I explain to him why maybe the house like that, or why I put some food on the fire. Because it's not just the housework alone you have to do, you have kids to take care of. You know, so violence on the whole of women, I believe, you know, it have an advantage, it's wrong.
Some men just, you know, take too much advantage of women. Some men, you know, they don't like, well, for instance, they have a jealousy about them too. So I think that's why they try to abuse women.
It is very sad to see men abusing women when they're supposed to be protecting them. Way back, it was more, people didn't used to talk about it much, and you know, it used to be at the home, but now it's out in the open, and men abusing women more, and more violent. Long time, right? The woman used to be at home, taking care of the house and the children, but now the women are working and taking care of them, themselves and their children. And they don't depend on the men anymore.
That care was this, it was something that I tell you, I cried just looking at that. Well, this man met this woman somewhere, I don't know, and I tell him, I said, it was a cutlass he had in his hand. But somebody turned and tell me, no, you have to look at the thing, there's a gun, the man beating the woman with it. It's a gun, yes, hitting. But after a while, I hear they say like he drank some poison. And then I see like the woman get up and walk and go on. So I said, oh God, and it happened when I see the woman get up. So I say to myself, run, but she ain't, like she ain't dead. It's like she hospitalized, maybe in a critical state. So I don't know, but that was something else to look at. Am I telling you? Jesus, how a human being could do that to another human being? And as far as I say, somebody that he interact with, he's not a teenager, he's a big full man, we're trying to tell me. He did nothing but life. I mean, he's a big man, what kind of example is setting for the younger ones behind? What kind of pattern you setting behind? And then after that, you're going and drink poison. You understand? So that's the way to solve the problem. But communication is the word out here, you know? Communication. Trust. Understanding. If we don't know how to communicate, we'll always be in this jack of drama. But as I tell you, some of us are too hyper. We don't like to listen. Vice versa, male and female. We believe, you know, they raise you right way, my raise you wrong way. But this thing with violence, I believe it's going to get worse out here.